faith is rising tonight. Faith is rising tonight. Faith is rising tonight. Everyone needs compassion, love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Savior, the hope of nations. Yeah. Everyone, say.
Yeah. to celebrate tonight. Tell him how good he is where you're at. Just lift it up. Thank you, God. We celebrate you tonight.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, somebody. Welcome to the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Amazing Grace Assembly, where the love of God and the grace of God is simply amazing. Let's have a word of prayer together in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you so much for the privilege of fellowshipping together online. We thank you, Lord, because you are wonderful in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. We commit the word this Sunday into your hands. We ask, Lord, that as your word is released, everyone that comes in contact with your word, let it bring blessings to their lives in the name of Jesus. Let it bring wisdom unto them. Let it give them direction and inspiration, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you for this day. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. You're welcome to church. Today we will be looking at power of his might. The power of his might. In Ephesians 6, verses 10 and 11, which is our text, Ephesians 6, 10 and 11. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. The key word there is the power of his might for this Sunday. Paul is admonishing the church at Ephesus, says to the brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Look, brethren, we are in a season that can easily be classified as perilous, very dangerous time we are in. Look at news all over the world. It's an evil time, unpredictably unpleasant things, agonizing times. And therefore, there's no better time than this to say to somebody, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. The might of God must be your shield. The might of God must be your strength. Hallelujah. From the time I entered the season of awareness in my life, I have never known or seen so many people that has passed on, you know, within this frame of time. Name it, all over the world, UK, USA, Nigeria, Africa, all over the place. Unprecedented. These are perilous times. The way of escape in this season is to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. In Proverbs chapter 18, verse 10, Proverbs 18, 10 says, "The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and is saved." The name of the Lord is a strong tower. You and I and everyone that cares really for their life and the future should come under the canopy of Jesus. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. You run into it and you will be saved. That's Proverbs 18:10. In Psalms 91 verses 4 to 6, Psalm 91 verses 4 to 6, it said, "He shall cover me with his feathers, he shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasted at noonday. Fear not." Why? You are covered with his feathers. Under his wing shall you trust. Then the truth of the Lord, which is the word of God, shall be your shield and buckler, and you shall not be afraid of any terror when you make his truth your shield and buckler. We need to take seriously putting on the armor of God. If you have not started doing that, I advise you right away start that. You put on the armor of God. In 2 Samuel chapter 22, 32 to 33, 2 Samuel 22, 32 to 33. "For who is God? Save the Lord. And who is a rock? Save our God. God is my strength and power, and he maketh my way perfect." God is my strength and power. At a time like this, only the Lord God Almighty can be our strength and be our power and shield us from these perilous times. You shall not be a casualty in the name of Jesus Christ. Your family shall not become casualty in the name of Jesus Christ. When we put on the armor of God, when we allow God to be our strength and our power. Hallelujah. You know, an example that we find in the Bible is the example of David facing Goliath. Goliath had been making a lot of noise, and the soldiers of Israel, they were tormented, they were intimidated. They were so afraid they could not go and face Goliath, you know. And David just came to the battlefront to say hello to his brothers and see their welfare and their state, to bring a report back to their father. And David heard Goliath making a lot of noise and said, "Oh, I'm going to go and fight this guy." And somehow they got him to the king, and the king, as it were, gave him the armor to go and fight David, because David is an experienced fighter. Look at what happened in 1 Samuel chapter 17, 38 to 39. Let us read that scripture, 1 Samuel 17, 38 and 39. Let me just quickly go to the scriptures. 1 Samuel 17, I look at 38 and 39. Let me read the scriptures to us, please. Hallelujah. Now, David said, "Moreover, the Lord had delivered me out of the paw of the lion and out of the paw of the bear. He would deliver me out of the hand of this Philistine." And Saul said unto David, "Go, and the Lord be with thee." And Saul armed David with his armor. Have you been relying on the armor of the world? And he put an element of brass upon his head. And also he armed him with a coat of mail. Verse 39, "And David gathered his sword upon his armor, and he had said to go, for he had not proved it. And David said unto Saul, I cannot go with this, for I have not proved them. And David put them off him." David put the physical armor off him. Brethren, what am I saying? That the armor of flesh does not profit. We need to be powerful in the Lord. We need the armor of God. We need to put on the strength of God. We need God for our power and our strength. Just like 2 Samuel 22:32-33 says that God is my strength and power. Hallelujah. Come under the rock. It says God will save us. Who is a rock? Is our God. Hallelujah. So David said, I cannot go with this. I've not proved them before. I've fought various kinds of battles before. I never relied on the arm of flesh. I can't do this now. I can't change the winning formula. The winning formula is God. Again, God. The winning formula is God. Again and again is God. You don't change the winning formula. Hallelujah. Be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. So David said, no, I can't go with this. And in verse 45 of that same chapter, 1 Samuel 17, verse 45, then said David to the Philistine, thou comest to me with a sword, and with a spear, and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defiled. Go against whatsoever that's coming against your life in the name of the Lord, and they shall be defeated. In the name of Jesus, they shall be defeated. David went in the name of the Lord. We need to run for cover. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and is saved. There will be safety for you. There will be safety for your spouse. There will be safety for your children. There will be safety for all of your investment. There will be safety all around you when you run into that strong tower, which is the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So David went, and David defeated Goliath for short. David made Goliath to fall by the power of Jesus, by the power of God. Goliath fell down flat. David cut off the head, raised the head, and showed Israel that indeed power belongs to God. The times are perilous. You can't do this by your strength. You can't face the world with all of the evil that is in the world by your strength. Run under the cover of God. Hallelujah. I want us to go back to Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 and 11. In our text, we said, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. What are we saying here? To be strong in the Lord and to allow his power of his might to overwhelm us entirely. Now, why should we be strong in the Lord? Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. Ephesians 6, 12 tells us that we wage not war against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against spiritual wickedness in high places, against the rulers of darkness of this world, you know, but that we do not war against flesh and blood. That's what he's saying. And therefore, we should know that all of the manipulations currently facing the world is a spiritual thing. The physical is a manifestation of the spiritual. There are things going on in the spirit realm, in the spirit world, warring against the earth. And the only way to face them and to have victory is to spiritually be strong in the Lord. Now, Ephesians chapter 6, 14 to 18. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness. So, it says in that verse 14, having your loins girt about with truth, the breastplate of righteousness. Verse 15, your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, preaching the word. Verse 16, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. Verse 17, the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit. Verse 18, praying always with all prayers and supplication in the Spirit, watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Hallelujah. So these are the things that we need to strengthen. And let's dive deeper into all of that and see what the Bible is talking about. Truth. What are we to strengthen? Truth. Zechariah chapter 8, verse 16 to 17. Zechariah chapter 8, 16 to 17. These are the things that ye shall do. Speak ye every man the truth to his neighbor. Execute the judgment of truth and peace in your gates. And let none of you imagine evil in your hearts against his neighbor, and love no false oath. For all these are things that I hate, saith the Lord. So what should we strengthen? Truth. Speak truth to your neighbor. Speak truth to one another. Execute judgment of truth and peace in your gates. As we dwell in all of that, we are shielded from these perilous times. That's the implication. What else are we to strengthen? Righteousness. Proverbs chapter 28, verse 1. Righteousness. The wicked flee when no man persuades, but the righteous are bold as a lion. So when you strengthen righteousness, you become strengthened and bold as a lion. And you know as it is that in the forest, in the wild, there's no animal that can just challenge a lion anyhow. So when we strengthen righteousness, we are strengthening ourselves in the Lord by becoming bold as a lion. And therefore, the evil and the perilous times will give way. We need to strengthen the truth. We need to strengthen righteousness. What else again? Let's look at Jeremiah 23 verse 8 for righteousness. Jeremiah 23 verse 6. In his days, Judah shall be saved, and Israel shall dwell safely. You shall dwell safely. And this is his name whereby it shall be called, the Lord our righteousness. You know, when the Lord's righteousness is imputed into your life, what happens is that you become strong in the Lord. The power of his might will be available for you. You'll be as bold as a lion. What else should we strengthen? Preaching undiluted gospel. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 1 to 4. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 1 to 4. I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke. Exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth and shall be turned unto fables. So one of the things that we need to strengthen at this time is preaching undiluted gospel. Let the gospel be preached from our hearts, not to please men, not to excite men, but to bring the kingdom of God to bear upon the lives of the people. And thereby the peoples are strengthened. Hallelujah. We need to strengthen preaching on diluted gospel. What else again are we to strengthen? Faith. In Hebrews 11:6, but without faith it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. So faith is what we need to strengthen, because from it we'll be able to quench the fiery darts of the devil, quench the fiery darts of the evil ones, quench the fiery darts of this wicked world. Faith needs to be strengthened. What else do we need to be strengthened? Salvation. There are various kinds of salvation these days. Remember in those days when people give their lives to Jesus Christ, they come to the altar in tears, genuinely repentant, you know, of their sins, of their wayward ways, and coming to make a commitment to God sincerely from their heart and dedicating their lives to Jesus and asking God to take over their lives completely, every aspect of their lives. We need to go back to those old days and strengthen salvation. Salvation is key. Matthew chapter 24. Matthew 24, verses 12 to 13. And because iniquity shall abound, you can see all around us, iniquity is abounding. The love of many shall wax cold. People are getting cold. Somebody says, a believer, you cannot believe what he's doing. That can you be a believer and be acting this way? Says, love of many shall wax cold, but he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. Hebrews 10:23. Let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering. For he is faithful that promised. You can check Revelation chapter 3, verse 10 to 11 when you have the time. You know, all of this is, you know, being emphatic about strengthening salvation. Holding fast. Come on, somebody, hold fast to your salvation. Hold on to that old rugged religion. Hold on to that rugged faith of yours. Go back to your archives and take hold of that faith. Not as it is in the present day. that people say, I mean, they speak the language as well. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. But it has nothing to do with their day-to-day living. Their lives is not a reflection of the salvation that they profess. Here it is really being emphatic and is also encouraging us in Hebrews 10:20 that hold fast the profession of our faith. Do not waver. What else do we should we strengthen? Sword of the Spirit. The sword of the Spirit. We need to strengthen that. In 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 15, it says in the Bible, study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. We need to strengthen the word, the study of the word, putting the word in our system, in our heart, so that we can speak the word. The word is like the sword in the spirit realm, breaking and shattering every barrier, destroying every arsenal of the enemy thrown at us. Is the sword of the Spirit, is the word of God. It is important to strengthen all of these areas of our lives. In Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12, Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12, the Bible says, for the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Hebrews 4:12. So it shows that the word of God, it can run so quickly. It is very powerful. It can divide asunder. It says it's sharper than any two-edged sword. That a sword that has two edges, that the word of God is sharper than all that. And it can pierce through things. It can divide asunder soul and spirit. The word of God is life, is living. We need to strengthen the area of the word. That's why the word of God must be preaching truth. And it should be shared in the rhema of the word, not in the logos, because the letter kill it. But the rhema, the revelations, give it life. So we should strengthen the word, the rhema, the sword of the spirit at these perilous times, because it will really be a blessing to us. Finally, what should we strengthen? Prayers. We need to pray, brethren, more than ever before. I cannot overemphasize that. We need to pray. If you have not been praying before, get up and pray. You need to pray in the night. You need to pray in the morning. You need to pray while you're driving your vehicle. You need to pray while you're sitting behind the vehicles and the drivers are driving you. You need to pray in the bathroom, in the washroom. You need to pray. You need to pray everywhere in the kitchen. You need to pray. Hallelujah. You need to pray all the time. What does the Bible say? 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 17. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 17. Pray without ceasing. That's the encouragement. That is praying ceaselessly, praying continuously. Oh, should you be on the knees praying 24 hours a day? You don't need to be on your knees when you want to pray alone. There's a time for you to be on your knees to pray when you're in your closet. But when you're driving, you can't be on your knees driving. But you can be on your knees in your heart while you're driving your car and you're praying. Hallelujah. You can be in the washroom having your shower and you're praying. And if you love that, you can kneel in the shower and praise the Lord and pray. This is the time that we need to invest time, invest quality time to pray. It's a season to invest quality time in prayers. Because as you pray and bombard heaven and bombard your environment, the fire of God will just come, you know, engulf you entirely. And wherever you go, you are shielded from the evil of the world. You are shielded from the wickedness of the world. The arsenal thrown to you by the devil and his host. Oh, you'll be shielded because of the name of Jesus Christ that you have called in your time of prayer. And prayer is a weapon. Using the word of God and praying with them. And as we do this, God will be glorified in our lives. The power of his might in righteousness, in truth, salvation, faith, you know, sword of the spirit in prayers, then you'll be empowered by his might and you'll be a formidable personality that wickedness cannot overcome. I'm inviting you into that. Make a decision today for Jesus and say, enough of your struggling. Enough of your using your strength trying to fight your battles by yourself. Enough of you throwing yourself into the world, into this perilous time. It's hazardous to do that. I'm calling you into the Lord Jesus Christ. Make a change of your ways today. Just change your mind and say, Lord Jesus, I accept you as my Lord and my Savior today. I repent of all of my ways, that I've lived my life, have been the government to myself. I want your government to rule over my life henceforth. Come into my life and be my Lord and be my master and guide me in all of the affairs of my life. And as you do that, as you run into that strong tower, you shall be saved and you shall be shielded from this perilous time. And you become empowered by his might in the name of Jesus Christ. I bring you salvation right into your home there. Open your heart and receive Jesus and you will never be the same again. Praise Jesus. Let's bow our heads to pray. Father, we thank you so much for this Sunday. I thank you, Lord, for all those ones that are surrendering their lives to Jesus Christ. They've accepted you as their Lord and their Savior. Lord, I pray that they will begin a new life. You will shield them in these perilous times. Oh, Father, I pray that the weapons formed against them shall not prosper. Every tongue that rises up against them in judgment, we condemn in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I pray, oh God, that you will sweep across the world, Father, and shield, oh God, everyone that calleth the name of the Lord. Shield them from destruction. Shield them as you have promised. You have promised that you will be our banner. You have promised that you'll be our shield. Shield everyone in the name of Jesus that calleth upon the name of the Lord. We pray, oh God, that there shall be great salvation at this time. There shall be great salvation in this season, in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord, for your word. We bless your holy name. Thank you, everlasting Father. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we prayed. Amen and amen and amen. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord watch over you. I'll see you next Sunday. Be blessed.